by the school council table to say a few words to Bruce and Jane on behalf of the parent body. The sea that calls all things onto her calls me, and I must embark. Bruce, as you and Jane embark on your journey to India, we wish you all the best. Jane, the Saville Library is what it is today because of all your hard work, your dedication, your love of books and children. To you, Bruce, a heartfelt thank you for your leadership during these past 4.5 years. You came to BSV at a critical time. You were given a mandate, and you delivered. During many of our conversations, Bruce would often highlight the stellar qualities of the teaching staff, their dedication, and their ability to inspire students to think outside the box. A teacher who is indeed wise does not bid you to enter to the house of his wisdom, but rather leads you to the threshold of your mind. This is a true hallmark of this institution, the British School of Boston, a school that you are all lucky to be a part of. Today, Bruce and Jane, you're going to hear many good difficult, but a farewell, un arrivederci, un adios. Vedante Virginia is necessary before you can meet again, and meeting again after moments or lifetimes is certain for those who are friends. Thank you and bon voyage.
Council to say something on behalf of the students in the school. As a member of the student council, it is an honor to speak on behalf of the primary school students.
Dr. Robinson, we are all sad to see you move on, but are happy for you and Mrs. Robinson as you leave on such a great adventure. You have made a great impression in your time here, and we thank you for all you have done for us and for our school.
There's a Native American belief that every step you take leaves a footprint, and that with each footprint, part of you becomes part of the earth. Dr. Robinson, you have taken many steps in our school, and part of you will always be here with us at the Brave School.
Your love of people, learning, and fun have helped us to make us a better school, and we know that you will make your new school in India wonderful as well. Many of us remember your singing, Halloween costumes, visits to our classes and camps, and ever-present smile.
Each week in Assembly, we celebrate the personal goals and talk about how they are important to us. You have modeled all of them in your time here as our head teacher. Morality, resilience, thoughtfulness, adaptability, communication, inquiry, cooperation, and respect. We thank you for being a role model.
As you move on to another exciting chapter, please take these final words with you. They are a quote from William James, the American philosopher, who said, "Act as if what you do makes a difference." It does.
Thank you, and good luck.
Thank you all so much. If I could ask Shruti to come up now, she is from the
thank you. Lovely songs. Have a good time in India.
Thank you for being such a good headmaster. I hope you like India very much. I wish you good luck.
You have been a really good headmaster. I hope all the kids at India like you.
I hope you have a wonderful trip to India and you enjoy your new school.
My favorite memory from when Dr. Robinson was teaching, or when he was here, was when his first assembly, he taught us a song called Give Me a Home Among the Gum Tree, and that was his introduction to us. And I really liked it because it's a really jolly song, and it's from his home country, and he really likes it, and it really gives us a happy feeling. And he introduced himself, and it made us feel like he was a really nice person and kind. And so I just want to say that thank you so much, Dr. Robinson, and I wish you all the best in your new school.
Hope you like your new school. We wish you well.
Dr. Robinson is a playing piano machine. Bye-bye, Dr. Robinson.
I'll always remember the time when I was here to learn English and you were always there asking us questions and talking to us. And I'll never forget you, and I hope you'll do really well in your new school. Thank you for being our headmaster.
Dr. Robinson is a music master. Bye-bye, hope you have fun in India. Hope you come back soon.
I remember when you played fun songs on the piano, and my favorite was the green pea. Goodbye, Dr. Robinson, and I hope you have good luck in India.
I always remember how Dr. Robinson used to come to our assemblies on Friday and sung songs with us, and they were always so happy and full of friendship, and everybody always was happy to join in. Thank you, Dr. Robinson, for making my time at the school so happy and exciting, and good luck.
I remember Dr. Robinson visiting my classroom, and I really enjoyed it. Good luck in India.
Dr. Robinson, I remember you teaching me math in year 4, the 11 times table. It was really funny. I enjoyed it. Good luck in your new school, and I hope it's the same as this one.
Yeah! happiness, more or less. It's just a change in me, something in my living.
Dr. Miss Robinson, I was asked to speak on behalf of the staff, say a few words about both of you. Bruce and Jane joined BSB in August 2007. This was Bruce's fifth headship, coming to us after leading two schools in Australia and two in India. One thing that was clear to all of us when Bruce joined us was what a compassionate, kind and family person he was. Bruce and Jane have been married for almost 37 years and have two children, Miriam and Neil, who are both a long way away in Australia. They also have two enormous German Shepherd dogs, Mac and Tosh, both of whom will be going back on the aeroplane to India with them next week. In the absence of his own children, Bruce is always worried about all of the staff here as if they were his own. Being a head in an international school requires wearing a lot of hats. He's always maintained a balance between the different aspects of his role. And I know I speak on behalf of all of the staff about how he's had the welfare of the students, staff and families of BSB at the forefront of his vision. He has supported the staff both behind the scenes and on a personal level to ensure the well-being of all of his staff. In his time at BSB, amongst other things, Bruce has worked really hard with all of our staff to establish a more learning-focused school. He's worked hard to establish consistent administrative procedures and processes and worked really hard to improve all of our communication. When I asked the teachers, when I asked the teachers what they would most miss about Bruce, they replied, his sincerity, his positivity, sense of fairness, compassion, and his love of children. What a way to go, Bruce. Jane also has brought a huge experience of international leadership. She was a deputy head of a large primary school before she came here, and a library consultant, which says it all about our library, 250 schools in Sydney before she came here. Not a deputy head of 250 schools, my dad's a library consultant of 250 schools in Sydney. Jane has done an absolutely fabulous job for the Southern Library, and Vera has already said. We are so thrilled with our library. Jane has increased the library resources from 1,000 to 12,000 books. Without your resilience and determination, Jane, that wonderful resource that is our school library would never have come to fruition. For this, teachers and students will be eternally grateful, and we will, for years to come, cherish our library, so thank you. Jane has also built great working relationships with many of the teachers and parent volunteers, and we hope we will continue to manage the library as well as you've done. I don't think we ever will, but we'll do our best. Jane's best kept secret is that she's been quietly studying a diploma in aromatherapy, which she hopes to use as she goes on to India and then one day back to Australia. Bruce and Jane, I know I'm going to pronounce this wrong, but Bruce and Jane are moving to Lavasa and then to Pune. Is that right, Bruce? Tell me I was pronouncing it in too English a way yesterday. Pune, right?
Pune, correct.
Ah. He will be taking up a new role as head of school at Lamont High School, which will be opening in a new city, completely new city, with 170 students, and they plan to grow to over 1,000 students. And he is also going to be responsible for planning and developing new schools in India. Are you taking over a whole new city, Bruce?
Not quite.
Bruce will be president of India before we know it. Bruce and Jane leave us, I could have gone on forever about Bruce, but both of you leave us with such happy memories. Many of you students won't know this, but when you've gone home in the evenings, Bruce used to disappear downstairs to the bottom floor and play the piano, loudly, very loudly, and sometimes even sing very loudly. You would hear piano coming the whole way up the school. We will also miss Jane's passion and depth of knowledge about the world of books. I know she's inspired a lot of your love of reading, so we'll really miss that as well, Jane. And how will we ever forget Dr. Robinson's starring role in the pantomime, dressed in a fetching pink tutu, with his sparkly wand. Bruce, you have been an inspirational leader, a great friend to all of us. and we will really, really miss you. We're very sad to see you go, but we know you'll have a fabulous new life. We're very excited because you'll have a lot of people to iron your shirts and drive them around, isn't it? So he hasn't had that yet, but we know that you'll have a very exciting new life, and we'll miss you as a friend and a leader, but we hope you'll come back and visit us at BSB. Thank you for being great.
I have been truly touched this morning by the heartfelt expressions of the appreciation, love, and support shared by our students and our school community members. That a school is not a building, it's not the facilities, or it's not the program. The school is the people. And the people is what has made BSB what it is today. Students, teachers, and parents. Mrs. Robinson and I have made enduring friendships during our time in Boston, and we will cherish these friendships and relationships forever. As we heard in the presentation this morning, people are going to miss us, and I can assure you we are going to miss you very much as well. I want to speak to our students. I will miss your smiling faces. The waves and the smiles in the corridors, the singing in assemblies, and above all, the commitment I have seen to your studies. Learning at our school is first class, and our students are dedicated learners. I am very proud of what you as students have achieved in your learning. I feel privileged to have led a school so focused on learning. And I'm very proud of what you've achieved, and I expect to hear great things about our students, each and every one of you, in the future. To our teachers and learning assistants, the achievements of the school over the past 4 years could not have been made without the hard work and commitment of our teaching faculty and learning assistants. Your dedication and your care for our students continues to be an inspiration to me. As I move around the school and watch the level of support for our students by our teachers and learning assistants, it continues to amaze me. And I know I've had a number of discussions with Mrs. McPhee since she joined us, and I know she feels the same way, that there is just a wonderful sense of belonging and care and learning in our school. And I think that is something that we can all be proud of. I want to especially mention the senior leadership team. Ruth Williams, Ems Northey, Andrew McRae, Anna Vangel, Sarah Dolan, Stuart Dunster, and Lisa Van Horn. They've supported me so much over the time I've been here, and I value your loyalty, your commitment, and the intellectual stimulation that you have provided. I also would like to mention our administrative staff. Judy, our business manager, Maureen, who could not be with us today, she's ill. You may remember Dena, who worked in the office for us for 2 years. She was a great support for us. Rachel, with David Simonton. David, without his help, we would not function as a school. So I do want to thank David very much for his help. And I also want to mention someone who is often forgotten in the messages of appreciation in the school, but I have appreciated this person's work immensely, and she has contributed greatly to our school, and that is Marge Slater, who has ably been running our after-school care program for, I believe, about 8 years. So thank you, Marge. Your efforts have been appreciated. BSB has a special relationship with Showa, and Dr. Ron Provost's professional and personal support and the support of his staff and faculty has been invaluable as we've expanded our campus and worked towards sharing this wonderful facility. Now I want to address my comments to the parents. I want to thank you for putting your trust in me. I remember 4 years ago standing in the library and someone shaking their finger at me and saying, Dr. Robinson, you've got 1 year to turn this place around. I don't know if that person is still here now, but I think we've turned the place around. I want to thank the parents for their support. Your trust in my leadership and supporting the strategies that I implemented enabled us as a collective community to transform our school. And I think it's now been transformed into a vibrant, caring, learning-focused community that it is today. And that's because we've all worked together collaboratively, every member of the school community, working to the one goal. The loving and caring nature of our school community was most recently demonstrated during Mrs. Robinson and my personal crisis after the floods in Australia. We will never forget the personal, emotional and financial support generated within the school for our family following Alex. I've also been supported in my role at the school over the past 2 years by Anne McPhee, who has represented world-class learning schools, and her guidance and friendship is valued and appreciated. And I know she's having just a whale of a time being in school at the moment and acting as our interim head until Paul Wiseman arrives later in the year. So thank you for Anne for your support. I've been privileged to lead our school over the past 4 years. And I leave our school knowing it is in a good place. I firmly believe our school will continue to develop and become one of the leading schools in Boston. Departing is bittersweet, but our life journey continues. You will remain in our hearts as we leave and move to India. And before I finish the quotation, I would like to thank one more person. They say a good man needs a great woman. I have. I want to finish by quoting a 19th century philosopher by the name of Apollonia. He said this, "Come to the edge," he said. "We cannot. We are afraid." He repeated the call, "Come to the edge." The people came to the edge. He pushed them and they flew. My prayer is that you will all continue to fly. God bless you.
It needs to be three cheers from the British School of Boston. Are we ready, everyone?